Hello, this is Michael Sulock. For this video, we're going to do two example problems from the book and learn a new function to use with our calculator in the process. So this is number 41 from section 7.2, and the variable we're talking about here is the lengths of human pregnancies. We're told some pretty important information here. These things are normally distributed, and we've also got the mean, and we also have the standard deviation. So for a problem like this that asks for a proportion, that's asking for the area under a normal curve. And not just any normal curve, the normal curve with this mean and this standard deviation. So I've mentioned that it's a really good idea to draw pictures. We're looking for more than 270. I'm thinking that the mean is 266, so 270 is going to be a bit above the mean. And because we're looking for more than, we want the area to the right. So this area is the answer to question A. So how are we going to do this? We're trying to find the area under a normal curve. So we need to use our normal CDF function. Oh, I need to label 270 on here. That's pretty important. Not a really good picture without that. We've talked about how normal CDF needs four numbers. And the first two are for the area. And the second two are for the distribution that we want to find the area of. So those area numbers, your calculator might refer to them as the lower and the upper. The third number is always going to be the mean of the distribution. And the fourth is always going to be the standard deviation. We want to start calculating the area here at 270. That's the smallest value we want to use. That is going to be our lower number. And then the upper number just needs to be something big. I'm going to use 1,000 here. You could use 10,000. Just don't use 275. That's not big enough. So anyway, we're going to put the mean here and the standard deviation here. When I evaluate this in my calculator, I'm going to get 0.4013. This should not be a 2 because I had to round it up. So what proportion of pregnancies last more than 270 days? 40.13% of them. And we found that by using our normal CDF function because it was the area under a normal curve. So then we're asked for a similar question. What proportion of pregnancies, but now it's less than a given number of days. If these are my pregnancies, not mine personally, then we're looking for the area to the left of 250. Just like before, we're going to use normal CDF. Because we're working with the same distribution for this whole problem, these last two numbers are actually always going to be the same. This is always going to be the mean. This is always going to be the standard deviation. For the entirety of this problem, we're going to use 266 and 16. And now for the lower, we want to tell this thing where to start, and we want to start low. We want to start calculating an area that's quite a bit to the left here. So we can just sort of go crazy, and I'm going to put in negative 1,000. And then 250 is going to be the upper because that's where we want it to stop. And you'll notice that this is one standard deviation below the mean because the standard deviation was 16. And according to our empirical rule back in the day, we knew that this should be about 16%. And this calculator gives us a more exact answer. It's 0.1587. This should not be a 6. You got to round correctly here. So we've got 15.87% of pregnancies last less than 250 days. So then we're asked for another proportion, but we want to know between two numbers. So again, we're working with the same distribution centered on 266 days. And we want to know what's going on between 240 and 280. So this is an interval question, but it's still an area under a curve. And it's still an area under the exact same normal distribution we've been working with. So, like I said, we're going to put the same mean and the same standard deviation, but now the two numbers that we're given here are going to be put into our function because we want to start at 240 and we want to end at 280. And that gives us the appropriate area under this curve. And when we do that, we get 0.7571, which is 75.71%, which our picture kind of helps us realize that this is reasonable. The area was fairly large, so the fact that we're getting over a half here kind of is being verified by our picture. So that's another reason why the pictures are helpful. They help you keep the where you want to start and stop straight, and they also give you a chance to ask yourself, does this look right? Part D is asking for a probability, but we've said that finding probabilities works the same way as finding proportions. They're both just areas under the curve. So we're looking for the area because we want more than. It's always, you have to be very careful reader in this class, that we're looking for the area to the right of 280. So I'm going to use normalcdf. I'm going to start at 280. I'm going to stop at something very large because, again, I want to just keep calculating this area until I get to the upper value, which I'm going to put in as 1000, which this is not to scale, but I'm telling it to calculate this area for a long time. And it's the same mean and the same standard deviation. So we get 0.1908, 19.08%. Part E wants another probability, and this time it wants the probability that it lasts no more than 245 days. So what does no more mean? That means less than 245. So 245 is somewhere down here below the mean. You don't have to be really perfect with these pictures, but especially putting them below or above the mean is going to be helpful making your picture accurate. So we want to use normal CDF, and I'm going to use a very low number to start. Let's use negative 1000. And you have to be careful is that when you're doing negative numbers in your calculator, there's a button that looks like this right beside the dot on the very bottom row, and that's the button you want to use. Don't use the subtraction symbol, which appears right under addition. Even though they're both horizontal lines, this one is just for subtracting two numbers, and this one is for saying a number is negative. So that means we need to end at 245, the same mean and the same standard deviation. And I get 0.0947, if I round correctly, which is 9.47%. So then the last part to this question is a little bit different. It says a very preterm baby lasts less than 224 days, and is this unusual? And if we want to know if something is unusual, we better know the probability of it. Because if we don't know that, we really have no idea whether it's unusual or not. To find the probability of this thing, we just need to do what we've been doing, which is to find the area to the under the curve to the left of 224. We're going to use our normal CDF function, and then I want to stop at 224, and I want the same mean and the same standard deviation, 0.004. 3.32. I'm using a few more digits here because when I change this to a percent, I like seeing more than just a few digits to be more precise. It's less than half of percent. So is that unusual? Well, it means that in 1,000 babies, on average, we expect to see about 4 of them being preterm. I would say that's fairly unusual. So number 41 uses normal CDF in every single part of it because it's always asking for either probabilities or proportions, and those are all areas under a normal curve. Let's look at a problem that still involves a normal distribution but is asking for a different kind of information. It's kind of going to be going backwards. And so let's look at number 47 from this same section. And this problem is similar to the last one. We're still talking about things that are not born yet, but in this case, we've got some eggs. And we're talking about the incubation time for chicken eggs. And they give us a number here that's actually a bit of a distraction. This is just saying, hey, every egg we're talking about for this problem is going to be supposing that it was incubated at this temperature. We're not actually going to need to use this temperature in this problem anywhere. What we need to know is the fact that they're distributed normally. That's important. These incubation times are distributed normally. And we've got the mean here. They don't give it to us in symbols as directly like they did in the last problem, but this is the mean. They say the word mean. And then this number one right here is the standard deviation. And so the first problem asks for the 17th percentile for incubation times. We've mentioned that percentile is the percent below. Notice this problem is giving us a percentage. It's giving us the area under the curve, and it's saying, hey, I want you to find the incubation time. That's the 17th percentile. For this problem, our answer is going to be a number of days, and specifically the number of days such that 17% are less than that number of days. So normal CDF is not going to be able to do this for us because that requires us to give it two values and that tells us a percentage. So we need a new function, and the very next one underneath normal CDF is what we want. It's called invNorm, and this INV stands for inverse. So this is a different function, and inverse, it's kind of saying, hey, it's doing the opposite. So this function, instead of telling the function what interval we want and it telling us the area, we're going to be doing the opposite. We're going to give it the area. And specifically, the way this function works, especially if you have an older calculator, is that you're always going to give the percentile, which is the area below. And you need to do that as a decimal. So what I mean is 17% is a percentage, but as a decimal, that's 0.17. So that's what we need to put in inverse norm. Inverse norm always gives us a percentile, actually. And this area below value, the first number we give this function, is going to be the percentile we want. And just like the third and fourth numbers of normal CDF, we need to tell it which distribution to use. So we need to give it the mean and the standard deviation of the distribution we're using. So this is coming from a distribution with a mean of 21, like we said, and a standard deviation of 1. So there's only three numbers in inverse norm. That's important. There's four numbers for normal CDF, but only three numbers for inverse norm. They share the idea that they both need the mean and standard deviation, but inverse norm needs the area below instead of the upper and lower values. So anyway, when we smash this into our calculator, we're going to get the 17th percentile of incubation times, and we get 20.05. And what is that? It's the number of days. It's this incubation time here. We found that 20.05 is the 17th percentile. And we did that using a new function, inverse norm. And part B asks for the incubation times that make up the middle 95%. The middle 95%. This is where a picture is really going to help. Because what does that mean? Okay, here's my distribution of egg times. In the middle of that distribution is 21. But I want to know two numbers, actually. A lower and an upper. So that the area between them is 95%. 95%, that's centered right on the mean here. That's what the middle 95% is. So hopefully I'll realize that what I'm doing here is I'm trying to find percentiles, and I need two of them, but I'm not actually ever going to find the 95th percentile. So there's 100% in this entire curve, which means that there's 5% total outside this middle area of 95%. And because this thing is symmetric, and we're looking for the middle 95%, that means that half that 5% is below my interval, and half that 5% is above my interval. So what am I really looking for? I'm looking for the two numbers. I need the lower thing here, which is the 2.5th percentile. And I also need the upper, which is the what? It's the 95 plus 2.5. It's the 97.5th percentile. So how am I going to find these percentiles? I'm going to use inverse norm because that's what that function does. And we said the first number the inverse norm needs is the percentage below as a decimal. So because this is the number that has 2.5% below it, the decimal is 0.025. And we're still working with the same distribution that we did before. So we're still using a mean of 21 and a standard deviation of 1. And when I do that, I get 19.04, and that's a number of days. And then to find the upper value here, I need to use inverse norm again, and I'm going to use 0.975 because I want the 97.5th percentile, same mean, same standard deviation, and I get 22.96, and that is also a number of days. The middle 95% here are between what two numbers of days, basically, and I just found that. It's between 1904 and 22.96 days. So 47, these were two parts that both required using inverse norm because they both wanted to know what was the percentage below some value. And this one, it just gave me the percentage that it wanted, so I just stuffed that into the calculator. But for B, I had to be a little bit more careful and realize that the middle 95% means that what I'm really looking for are these two percentiles here. So anyway, hope that was helpful. I will see you next time.